Welcome to the High Vibes Reset. My name is Kyle Gray. I like to describe myself as your boy because I am your spiritual running buddy on this four-day reset. Today, the lesson is all about tuning in. This is our opportunity to align with a higher power. And I'll say this, that the practice of tuning in is one of the most beneficial things that you can learn in order for you to maintain your vibration, in order for you to look after your energy. Because when we take the opportunity to tune in, we take this opportunity to remove the space that is between us and the higher power. Now, when I'm speaking about the higher power, I'm speaking about the same thing that everyone is reaching up to in every religion and spiritual path across the world. For me, I like to call it the universe. Some people like to call it God, source, creation. Whatever you want to call it, it does not matter to me. But when I'm speaking about the higher power, I'm speaking about the energy that binds us all as one, the energy that is living in every single living being. It's energy that is everywhere. It's the everything that is, was, and ever will be. And it's the same energy that I'm speaking about when you hear a physicist speak about the quantum field. It's just this energy that is connecting us all as one. So when we are tuning in, we're setting this intention to remove the space between us and that higher power. Now, we've already discussed that we are united and connected with the everything that was, is, and ever will be. And this message is not new. It's something that every spiritual teacher across the world has spoken about in their message. It's been shared by the likes of Jesus Christ to Bob Marley. From the Buddha to Krishna. It's this idea that we are connected with our source. Now, we are connected, but sometimes, and most of the time in our day-to-day life, when things get busy and chaotic and overwhelming, we can forget that we're connected to the source. And so that's the space that I'm speaking about that we're removing. Because in the moments that we're dialed into our stress, our overwhelm, our uncertainty are the moments that we feel the space between us and our higher power is separate. And when we take a moment to tune in, we allow ourselves to remove that space and unite with our source once more. Now, the idea of tuning in is shared among many spiritual paths and many spiritual traditions. And I like to take a non-religious approach to my spiritual path. With that being said, if you go to any spiritual tradition or religion, you'll find that there's different versions of tuning in when you go and participate in rituals or ceremonies or gatherings. For example, maybe you go to the Catholic Church and they do the Lord's Prayer, you know, and everyone comes together in unison and they say this prayer together. And it can feel really powerful. It can feel connected. It can feel enriching. And I don't know about you, but if you've ever experienced that, there's something deeply spiritual, even if the words don't fully connect with you, or even if the religion doesn't fully connect with you, there's something really powerful about a number of people coming together and saying this prayer together. So that's a version of tuning in. It also reminds me of about 10 years ago, I was on my second trip to India and I was studying Ashtanga yoga in Mysore, India. And it's kind of in the south part of India. And I remember I was going to my first group guided practice. It was a Sunday morning. I was practicing with our teacher Saraswati at the time. And I remember getting there early. And I was super excited because I wanted to be in the front row. And as soon as I got there, I was waiting outside before we went in. It was such a synchronistic experience because here I was, this Scottish boy in the south part of India on his own. And who do I meet? Two girls from Edinburgh you know, the next city along, right there in the middle of India, and we all went in. And I remember when we all stood at the front of our yoga mats that day and our hands were in, you know, namaskar and prayer, and we did the mantra together, the opening call, the opening prayer of Ashtanga Yoga. And I remember every single hair on my body stood on end. And this feeling of coming home just entered my body. But it wasn't that I'd actually come home to India. The prayer took me home to myself. And that's what we're trying to do when we're tuning in. It's not tuning up or tuning down, it's tuning in. It doesn't matter what tradition or religion or practice you are involved in. The key is that the practice is taking you home to yourself. And when we tune into ourself, we also therefore tune into the universe, because the universe and us are one. And so when we remove this separateness through the practice of tuning in, then we're able to tap into this abundant source of support. And we're also able to tap into this feeling that there is more meaning and more purpose for our existence, because we are becoming and remembering that we are part of the bigger picture. So tuning in is such an amazing thing. And what I will say is that I'm going to be sharing a practice with you that will guide you to have the experience of tuning in. And this practice that I'm going to share with you is just an idea. So if you want to change anything about this practice or add your own prayers or change the method slightly, then I absolutely encourage you to do so. The most important thing you know about this journey through the High Vibes Reset is this is about you finding your own way of approaching these ideas. And the ideas that I'm sharing with you are simply ideas. This is about you finding and connecting with your own authentic voice. For when you do so, you create even more opportunity for you to be connected to your higher power. The other thing I wanted to say is that throughout this practice of tuning in, when I'm guiding you through it, I'm going to invite you to connect with your inner teacher. And the inner teacher is this ancient self. It's the part of you that has never left the source that you have come from. So I believe that we have all come from the same place, we'll all return to that same place, and because of that, it renders us as equal. Now, with that being said, we've come from source, we will return to source, and the truth is, we've never actually left source. There's still a figment of our being that is forever connected with the source of creation. And for me, that's the part of the self that I call the inner teacher. It's the part of us that was never born, and so therefore it's the part of us that will never die. And essentially, many people will call it the intuition, the conscious self. What I will say is that for me, the inner teacher is that expression of the soul. It's that expression of the soul that we can hear and connect with and actually have this visceral experience of. And so when we do the tuning in method, we're going to invite the inner teacher to stand at the forefront of the heart and mind. And we're going to invite that presence to lead the way. And that presence is the most intelligent aspect of you. It's the part of you that navigates from this source of love. And if you invite that presence to lead the way, it means in all aspects of your life, there is no separation between you and the higher power. So let's move into the practice of tuning in together so that we can remove that space between us and the higher power, so that we can allow a presence of love to lead the way. And in order for us to reset our vibes, it's essential that we have a connection to something that is greater to lead us through the experience. Now, let's go tune in. Welcome to the tuning in practice for day one of the High Vibes Reset. So thrilled that you are here.
Today we're going to do a practice to tune in and invite the inner teacher to stand at the forefront of your heart and mind. But before we do that, I want you just to find yourself in a comfortable seated position, whether that be on the floor or in a chair or on the sofa or in your car, it does not matter to me. It all works the same way. I like to sit on the floor, but I've been doing yoga for a long time, so it feels comfy down here for me. Wherever you are, I want you just to give yourself and your mind a moment just to be. And so we're just going to sit in silence for a couple of minutes just to let the mind do what it needs to do. And if the mind gets loud or obnoxious, or if you have a thought, just know that the mind is doing what it needs to do. And when you create space for the mind just to do what it needs to do, then you tune in, you'll have a more visceral, more clear, more succinct experience of connecting with your source. So just find yourself in a comfortable, easy position. And if it feels comfortable enough for you to do so, close the eyes down. If closing the eyes down feels uncomfortable for you, for whatever reason, you can just bring your gaze down. And just take a moment just to feel your breath moving in and out of the body. And if there's a part of your body that you know you're holding extra tension or stress right now, take a big inhale towards that part of your body. Hold the breath for 3, 2, 1, sigh it out. Doing that 2 to 3 times in your own breath cycle, taking your own time to do so. Taking a deep inhale towards that part of your body, holding for 3, 2, 1, sighing out. And then returning to your natural breath. And now just accepting the silence. Taking a deep inhale, a deep exhale, staying exactly where you are, just bring your awareness to something that you're grateful for. Thinking about something that lights you up from the inside. And that gratitude can be someone you love, a happy memory. It could be your health and well-being. But whatever you're grateful for, know that the gratitude you feel is generating this incredible light in the center of your being. And the light that is there is your light. Today you are encouraged and invited to to switch that light on and to bask in that light. And this light is like a spiritual car wash that washes through the entirety of your physical body and being. Washing away stresses and concerns. Washing away overthinking. Washing away distractions. And calling you back to the here and now. When you're ready, bring the palms together at heart center. Rub the palms together. Create heat and warmth. And when we rub the palms together, we activate both hemispheres of the brain, igniting the creative and the critical. And as you ignite them both, you allow them to become one. And once you've got that heat and warmth in the hands and in the palms, bring the thumbs into the chest. The elbows open out to the side, sitting tall in the spine, but in a way that feels comfortable, not causing any strain or stress or too much tension, just lifting yourself up. And setting an intention for yourself in this practice today and throughout this week. What is it that has brought you here today? What is the purpose for participating in this reset? And what do you want to experience from it? Set that intention now. And now setting the intention to remove the space between you and your higher power, the source of creation, the heart of the universe. And internally just saying, I remove the space between me and the universe. I recognize that we are one. And within you right now is this incredible voice of support, this presence of love, it's an intelligence that was not born and so therefore is eternal, and for the sake of this conversation we will call that the inner teacher. Call on your inner teacher right now. Invite the inner teacher to stand at the forefront of your heart and mind. Invite that inner teacher to lead the way. And if it helps you, you can visualize a golden light switching on at the heart center, glowing outwards. Like a torch leading the way up a dark path. There is a light inside of you that will lead the way through darkness and uncertainty towards your greatest good. Take a deep inhale, a deep exhale, and do a gentle bow to the inner teacher in you. Coming back up, allowing the arms to come onto the lap, taking another big inhale. Big exhale. And opening the eyes when you're ready. Congratulations, you have just tuned into your inner teacher. And in the moments of your life, you take this time to invite that presence to lead the way. You're creating an opportunity for you to experience more love, more connection, with more awareness of who you are and your part to play in the bigger picture. If you're craving more and you want to dive even deeper, below this video, you will find a corresponding lesson and meditation practice for you to take an even deeper dive to igniting this connection with the inner teacher within you. Thank you for being part of this High Vibes Reset. My name is Kyle Gray. I will see you tomorrow for part 2.